And 3, 2, 1, and action. You might remember me from previous episodes of videos on this channel. I hope you're all well. I'd like to get started. First, the pleasantries of the rainbow. The colors. Wonderful. As they are spread throughout life. So, from the rainbow, we get all sorts of things. And you know, this leads us to that covenant. So, you know, we're going to look at this. And what I want you to understand is the skeletal section of the hip area. And the view of it alone by itself right here. So kind of blink your eyes a couple of times. See how it looks like an elephant? That's your eyes and your mind working together. Just blink a few times. Staring right at it. That's you taking pictures of it. Now it's going to be in your mind. Okay? Now, I want you to look at the male reproductive system. Okay? This is fairly a good enough picture. But there's not one angle here that you should see. There are the combination of, why is all of them facing the left? There is the you'll understand later. There we go. So it is these pieces right here. Okay. That'll work. But you'll see the angle. Now, I want you to think about this. Now, this is what drives men, whether we understand it or not. Only through contamination. Science has already proven. It is the signals in your mind now, as you understand the womb and the eggs, or the basket of eggs. Now, I want you to look. This is where they messed up. Now, from a perspective, this is one hip bone. This is the other hip bone. The shape is still there. Remember when your hip breaks, when you get old, here's one ovary. Here's the other ovary. Here's the womb. Here's one testicle. There's the other testicle. This is the phallus. If you look at this image, these pieces laid out this way, it shows you something very unique. It shows you an upright being, a being that can walk upright. That's the difference between you and a cat, you and a dog. You and a bear, you and a fish. This is where it starts. The ability to walk upright, to balance thyself. Let us make them in our image, man and woman. And separate from that group, the children of Adam and Eve. Abel, the lamb, Cain, the murderer, Seth, the good son, one righteous, one wicked. This isn't about Democrats, it's not about Republicans, it's not about our version of good and bad. This Bible that most people want to ignore, abuse, or use as a tool of oppression clearly states the law that thou that created us has passed down to us for the way for us to act amongst each other. There's so many damning things that are in the Ten Commandments. Don't fuck your neighbor's wife when your neighbor's gone. Don't stab your brothers and sisters in the back and rob them. Don't covet their home, their tent, their belongings. Understand thou that created thee, and do not blaspheme his name. There is but one God. He has chosen you. He has freed you from oppression. Do not worship any other God. He's told you many things about himself. Including his name unto us, sons of man, sons of Noah, sons of Abraham, sons of Isaac, sons of Jacob. Out of all, he has chosen us. He's given us a task. Whether we choose to accept it or be judged like the Gentile. He's made everything in the shape of his creation. I've said this many times. Everything that is inside your system represents the different things that are outside of your system. From the length of your stomach comparative to the worm, your heart, the jellyfish, your bicep, the snail, your throat, your esophagus, the serpent, your hair like bushes, your arms, your veins like trees. To not accept creation and a creator is but your choice. I can't help that. I can show you some things that they don't want you to know because they're in control, like the scriptures say they would be. You are given a testimony. This is the same word that is used in a trial. Hence, the Creator says he is King of Kings and he will judge us all in the end. As they say, above is represented below, then our life sees judgment as a court system. Whether we see these things or not, these were our choices as we lived. To ignore these things, especially at such great time of turmoil, is truly ignorant. At some point, we must embrace our duties. Or our curses, they will not lift. We have to turn unto the Ishi Eloha. That, for people that do not watch all the time, that is the Hebrew translation of Lord God. A God is a Elohim. The highest, the most high, is the Eloha. Okay? We go over this a lot. So for people to act like they don't understand, that's sad. Now, I have not broadcast as much as I should have, or as much as I wanted to, because things have not come forward yet. Now those things have been revealed, and so we're going to go forward. Now, I hope everybody's ready for a wild, imaginative ride. And hopefully we'll discover some of the things that have been hidden from us. Now, as we understand, to view these things in a particular way, this is America. Yeah. We just want to party. This is North. This is South. So technically, you would flip this upside down. But notice how they have it. It's very, very, very revealing. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to go a little bit further, and we need to understand, in 1872. Just laying out some stuff. 1872. All right. The Jew, a Negro. So recently somebody left a comment and they stated, when did we go by Jews? Okay, so, well, I'll have to explain this. Now, I hope you're listening. Judea. Okay, if that's not like a good enough answer for you, I really don't know what is going to assist your thoughts in the direction of it's not your system, it's their system, and their system calls you whatever the hell they want. And because we were defeated and we are prisoners of war, and we are too ignorant to read a book. And we'll keep calling ourselves black because black people never did shit. Negroes created a lot, so they changed you from Negro. Whatever any of the Negroes were before, they changed you all to Negroes and niggers. And then to blacks. When black power got strong, they started changing it to African American. They control what you're called because you do not claim your own title. Anybody see the guy that calls himself Judah, but yet he calls himself a Moor? Moors are Moab. A Moabite will not be part of the congregation. Excuse me, congregation. What part of the Bible did he miss? We need to examine what everybody goes around preaching, the first five books. Because the first five books are going to answer all of this. So is the sixth book, Joshua. Yeshua. 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 It's going to answer all this. Nashua. So, I would suggest, because the book tells us Deuteronomy. We were supposed to remove all the Canaanites from the land. And it told us not to give our sons and daughters over. And it gave us a reason why. It gave us specific people. But like the food laws, we should understand why others should have been included on the list, but they weren't, because they tie back to the promises of the covenant. You see, you ever seen a buffalo up close? I have. I've been out there to Montana. Buffaloes are a trip. Buffaloes look like the Negro of the animal kingdom. Hey, the lamb, huh? The horned lamb. Buffalo is that true? Look at this one, like he's got an afro. Right? It's a trip, man. It's a trip. So, what they've done is they've classified everybody. And they have this big problem. Because M.W. Smith, shout out to M.W. Smith. M.W. Smith does a lot of work. Right? He shows us. In the book of Joshua or Deuteronomy, I can't remember, I think it's in Deuteronomy, that the long-haired chiefs were in the land. So when we focus on numbers and we find that we were with the Moabites. Excuse me. And we gave our sons over and gave our daughters over and we accepted their sons and daughters in these rituals. It was a great sin and punishment came. So it makes me think that when I watch these, videos that have these segments about Indians. In this video, there's a fight sequence. And one of the men call the Indian woman a mountain nigger. It really makes me question why the director had that being said. What do white people, excuse me, what do Caucasians that live in these areas, in these parts, understand about whom I call Magog? When you see a movie like Hell or High Water, there is a relationship between the two sheriffs that comes off very abrasive. But at some point, this is the discussion that they have.
Enjoy this little town.
Do you want to live here? Got an old hardware store. It charges twice what Home Depot does. One restaurant with a rattlesnake for a waitress. I mean, how is anybody supposed to make a living here?
People have made a living here for 150 years.
Well, people lived in caves for 150,000 years, but they don't do it no more.
Well, maybe your people did.
Your people did too. A long time ago, your ancestors was the Indians. Someone came along and killed them, broke them down, made you into one of them. 150 years ago, all this was my ancestors' land. Everything you could see, everything you saw yesterday, to the grandparents of these folks took it. And now it's been taken from them.
So even the Bible states that long-haired chiefs were here. Who they're descended from is really important. I believe they're Magog because for years, when you look at I've been saying that those people are related to the Asians, or what I previously believed are the Asians, but I believe now that they're just the Mongolians. I believe that Medicine Man broke it free when he showed in 1200, which is probably 200, Genghis Khan sent his people out And when you look at where they conquered, they start north of China and they go where? They go north. And as they go north, you have this the what? The Siberians. You know Siberia is what, this is the Siberian Pass, right? But why are they they're up here? The Eskimos are over here, right? The American Indians are throughout here. Then you had what? Something in the Southwest fighting the Indians before the white man. And you already know the Aztec, the Mayan, the Inca, the Brazilians, who the Bible surely claims. Remember, 1983, Congress is like, hey, Bible's fact. But you gotta be able to translate the mysteries. Thou shalt not kill, thou shalt not murder, but you stole this land, all the aboriginals enslaved, murdered, right? Aboriginals forced to the islands. Now integrating, hell no, we want island property. We want beachfront property. Marshall Islands nuked. Right? We just want to see what happens when we nuke the place and then set people back. You already watched, if you watch Netflix and you watched Marco Polo, every time he's talking to Marco Polo, this is from the history books. We've seized this, we've seized that, and we've seized that, and we're going for this. They took the north, the east ran, it took the west, something like that. And they were fighting the south in season two. And at the end of the season, hey, spoiler. The only problem is they're not going to show you the real image. They're not going to show you the Melanesian people, the Negritos that they pushed down here, the Han Dynasty, the Wang Dynasty, the dynasties that are gone. They're not going to show you that shit. Those dynasties are the same color. They lived here. They're the same color of the people that live here. India. Same color. Let me see. Nakis. Let me remember why I opened this. I'm gonna close these now. Understand the skeleton, or from my perspective, you don't have to accept it. I'm not trying to, hey, you guys hump like bunny. I'm not trying to give you any shit. I'm gonna get rid of the zones of migration map. I love that map. All right. So here's the. I haven't looked it up on the computer yet. I wonder what you could show me now. There you go. Nakis, China. Right? These are the people they don't want you to see. What did that say? Shang Dynasty. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm not trying. This is their museum pieces. Those are not white people. Edo. China. You've heard of Edo, fucking Edo time period. There's a damn place called Edo, Japan. You've got to understand what's going on. Every biblical race has been overthrown as predicted in the book of Daniel. This is not Anakis people. If these statues show black people, or what you would call black people, which are really melanated people being misnamed on purpose to hide their past, then clearly this is this person, no offense to anybody, this person looks no different than Jackie Chan. You can't have images of this from the dynasty that's written in history, and you say, well, this is the people. Those are two different fucking peoples. Somebody has what? Written the narrative. Wikipedia shows you these fucking people, but Google will show you these people. Now you see how that man's face grow. You see how dark he is. He's not a black person. He ain't got an afro. He look as dark as the people of India. Now, do you see what I'm saying? No offense. This is a fucking Mongolian or a Scythian. All we have to do is look at Wikipedia, and these are originally Iranian stock. The original what? Iranian. But when you look at the list of ethnicities, ethnos that are brothers, it's very different. Look at this. The Sith, the Saka, that's a brother. The Sake, that's a brother. Members of nomadic people by blood, originally of Iranian stock. So you've got to understand, whether you like it or not, you're in a game of risk. That is real. And you should all take the time to go listen to Francisco Perez's video about how Hawaii was overthrown by the colonizer. How they came with religion, took over resources, and controlled the output of the land, especially the amount of original people. Now again, Francisco will tell you his personal history in a heartbeat. He'll tell you who in his family had an afro. And he'll tell you his land was taken down the same way. He'll read it to you. In fact, I believe his wife is reading. No. I watch this. Why are Indigenous women missing in Canada? And you know what? This one's one of the keys to it all. I urge you, type in this title. You can see what the name of it is. And remember, I did the video I think it's the devil must have did it. where the judge smacks the guy on the wrist. He had this job in what airport? Strangled a woman of native, that title, right? Strangled her, masturbated over her, and she survived. And every time I talk to Vincent about this, he always talks about how, look how the judge talked to him, like he was a pet pissing on the couch. No, 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 you don't do that. And then right on the wrist. Probation. So think about something. I don't agree with history that's being presented. Something is left out. Because this is land theft in the north and the south. This is why when you look at the original images that the Aztec drew of themselves, you see the brown skin, and you know I read to you from the book, Mystery of the Mexican Pyramids, where Ulysses S. Grant brings millions of us, I mean Aztecs, up from Mexico. So if you slaughter millions of Aztecs and then you subdue 8 million and bring them up to build the railroads, and you and me know that the Negro built the railroad, now again, if we lived at a time where we mingled with another culture to the north of us, we mingled with another culture to the south of us. Again, read the book of Deuteronomy, read the book of Joshua. It tells you that Ephraimites and Manassites, they did not push all the Canaanites off the land. This is why people of South America look close to, they're a mixture of images of the what you look as the Negrito and the Hindu, I believe the Canaanites, and they're happy to paint on their skin that they're the Aztec or even the Mayan, even though the Aztec and the Mayan did not draw themselves that way. This is the whole point, what's actually physically on site versus what they collected versus what they tried to re-manifest. When you look at the Mayan were different. They left on their own, and you can completely see their structures all throughout North America, all the way up to Chicago. Now, a lot of people do not want to do the work. What they want to do is they want to come and listen, and then they want to go and talk to everybody. A lot of you that are viewing, you've seen this stuff through the years. I know some people are new. It is what it is. Now, I want you to keep something in mind. If these people, I was talking to Vincent about this, if these people are living on reservations, right, and they're not counted as American citizens, because in this you're going to learn that rape statistics are not kept, murder statistics are not kept for these women. The only difference is they're not citizens. They have their own country or reservation as a nation. Now again, the image of these people's face is tracked from Siberia all the way to North America and to parts of even California and New Mexico, but not much further. Now, you already know that the Aztec moved north on their own before the Spanish came and claimed the Four Corners. The Four Corners are the states, and I believe that has to do with historical markers because that's Colorado, New Mexico, Utah, and Arizona. Now, all these are the key, or all these states. A state is a mind, your sense of things. This is called a dry erase board because we agree it's a dry erase board. When things are named and the name is carried forth, we agree on these names. When they look at us and call us Negro, and we agree, then they're stuck. When they look at us and call us Black, and we agree, these things stick. Now keep this in mind. Just like these people have set in laws, you're an Indian, or for them, and you have a nation. It is the Indian nation who should be keeping track of these things because they're the ones that are losing people and these people are dwindling. Why would anybody think this is okay? Now, I want you to imagine something, right? They got this thing. The heritage of Negroids, right? So I started thinking, why would they call her a nigger, right? And then a mountain nigger. Then something came up, the one drop rule. See, you have an afro, you're running around calling yourself Black. You accept that. They are dealing with a legal classification, right? They're looking at you, there's no fucking doubt you're of Afro heritage. But when you look at their ancestry, all these people maintain their ancestral paleness, except for one group. One group. Take a wild guess. Magog. Think about that. I don't give a crap what they say right here. Because it's about the narrative. Now think about the one drop rule. And think about how Native Americans are treated. Right? Second of sons of Japheth, right? So, Magog, son of Japheth, is the daddy of the Iranians. Right? That's what he said. Well, let's go back. Originally Iranian stock. Okay. So Magog is the daddy of all these people right here, called the Scythians. Right? The Sith, Scythe, the Saka. The Chinese gone. If the Japanese look like the Chinese, they gone too. I'm not insulting nobody. They know what their heritage is. Their history is part of our history because their people came over and mingled with our people. They wanted land and somebody gave it to them. But something happened. Because it's clear the one drop rule affects Native Americans. Are we willing to see it? I'm not saying that 12 tribe chart is right, but what if that 12 tribe chart, we swap children with them? The Sake, the Isuz, excuse me, Isk Uziki or Ashkuzi, which is Ashkenazi. Eurasian. You know they pick and choose what they're gonna call them, right? Eurasian. What does that mean? Eurasian is Europe and Asia as one word, right? That's a large area. See, I've explained this is why that wall was built. Let me ask, hey, I'll tell you what. This is the question of all questions. If Alexander the Greek is a Greek, then when he dies, why does his four generals start cities of Rome? See? And you can answer that. Then you'll understand all of it. All of Ba-da-ba. Ba-da-ba. So, these are Magog's children. Now, why would Magog's children treat him like this? In real life, rape and murder is women. That's what this is. These people are gonna have the know. If we made treaties with them before the British came, these movies, the Caucasian openly shits on the Indian. Hostiles. Man makes a career of killing Indians in the military, then has a publicity He is ordered to take an Indian leader that he used to actually fight with in battle. That was captured in prison for 7 years. Seven. Then forgiveness. Biblical law, right? He is ordered to take him to the reservation that they are assigning him in Montana. Think a lot of this to me is very clear. I think a lot of people are choosing to ignore. So, it's kind of funny how when we look at oppression and we understand some of these groups, the Scathian archers shooting their bows in a style of archery influenced that of the Persians and subsequently other nations, including the Greeks. Now, as you come down, here's the history of Russia, Rus, Slavs. You're told you see princes on foot and slaves riding horseback. Pre-ninth century, they were slaves. Period. Do you see that? Everybody that has any kind of biblical respect of Judea falling should understand that word right there. Khazar and Khazaria. Every melanated person that talks Caesar Borgia should understand, even though that's some Italian Lombardo group, they should understand Khazaria. Now, as you go down, how many times have I told you about what? The Golden Horde. Why would they be golden unless they had what? Blonde hair. Some Russians have dark hair, but the top of, sorry to say it, but we really live into, the top of white supremacy is blonde hair, blue eyes. Grand Duchy, Dukes in Dutch. You don't want to read your Bible. Don't. Indo-Scythians. So, just gonna scroll down a little bit. Here, I remember something is in here. Here you have what? The word. So, three descendants from Indo-European propel shoot, right? Scud. All right. Now look, here it's Skud. Now watch. Same conversation. It's gonna change to SKO. All right. Now, what is the zero grade form of the same root? He restores the Scathians, the Scythians' self-name as Cuda, roughly as archer. Now, if you watch Marco Polo, they show a scene where they train shooting their bow from horseback. This is how the nomads survive. Hunted game, won war. This yields the ancient Greeks scuffs, right? An Assyrian Ashkuz, right? You already know the end of that. Ashkenazi. From Italistic Greek. A late Scythian sound change from D to L gives the Greek word skolati. That's the word skeleton. Right? All right, so hold on. Now remember, these people worship the dead. Worship my dead daddy. Worship my dead ancestor. That's what they love. They love the skeleton, skull and bones, right? All that stuff, right? Yeah, hold on. See that? That's the face of Mithra, the sun, right? All right, hold I'm just gonna put this here. There's the gnome, right? Skunk ha. King of Saka, right? That's the fucking gnome. That's his king hat, an engine funnel. Okay? I'm not, you see it right there in fucking stone. He's wearing a tunic and tall boots. Let's go further. And there it is. Right? Hold on. Be right back. Okay. So, here you have this discussion of the Sakas given in Chinese text. All right. So, this is the Han Dynasty. I wouldn't trust the image that's given just because of who's in control. They do not want you to truly understand because this is how they're controlling everybody. If you understand one nation is pretending to be somebody else in ruling their land, then at some point, you understand they've been colonized. And if people take in consideration if the fake Jews can, excuse me, if the Ashkenazis can go to Jew to go to court and claim that they're Jews when clearly they're not. They're going in front of courts that are pretending to be other people as well. If the French court say the French aren't Aboriginal and it's well known and well documented, then all these other lands that have been overthrown, it's well documented as well. This is a people's on a war terror. They are fulfilling a plan. I don't care whether they used Freemasonry or people believe this is what Freemasonry has always been. Instilled with, coded with. But all the information is here. To show who has done this. And the Bible tells us why they're doing this. Clearly tells us why they're doing this. Because this is what they've been tasked with. Let me thought I had a real fun one. I did. Now, whether people know it or not, there's an article that discusses that There is a doorway to the underworld in Siberia. I have said this. One of the viewers left a comment with the link to this. You have got to understand. It's rapidly growing. You've got to understand. They claim an ancient forest. This means the hole has been there for some time. Many times you've heard me make the statement, with there being a great wall built to keep these people in the north. This is why Genghis Khan would travel away from Europe. There's a giant freaking wall preventing him to go forward. Whether it's the mountains, whether it's the gate, Alexander the Greek, who's really Roman, built. Rome conquered the world. How else would Alexander be able to go? And who conquered the world for Rome? This is very simple when you just sit back and look at the pieces. So, many times I've stated over and over and over again, when this wall was created, there's only two ways out. Dig a hole to hell and come out the other side and unlock the gate. So, you can imagine it's something like this. Those nomads are horseback riders. Unless you're the most skilled, blah, 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 how are you going to get a horse, your supplies, over a mountain? As long as there's food, water, and women, you just keep feeding off the land because you're a nomad. Now, once there comes a point that those things do not exist anymore, that's going to cause you to want to leave. Of course, if a hole opens up in your land and you're a nomadic horseback rider, I don't think you're going to try to climb the wall just yet. I think you're going to examine the hole. And as you examine the hole and other brave people, whether it's in large groups, whether they trickle in, whether it's in small groups, they examine this. Either they find a way to somewhere else, or they find a way underneath the mountain system and out on the other side. It is clear throughout history, because the barbarians are locked behind the Great Wall, yet are able to fight in the Roman army as hired mercenaries, it shows one of two things. Either they had a way to subvert the wall, by going over, or they had a way to subvert the wall by going under. That's it. I don't even care if they destroyed a section of the wall. That's still going over the mountain to where it is. So as we examine those things, and then we start to see these different lands being overthrown in Europe and Rome. And we have something that follows what the Bible said, and again in the book of Daniel, especially revolving around the church. When you understand the church's control, then you understand that all these things, the mother harlot and all of its whores, as it is said, in their test. Again, one book is the testimony, the other book is the test. Their test gives you the mother harlot and her whore daughters. What do you think a denomination, what binds, even a child can understand these things. If you play a match picture game or match word game, then how can you not see all these are connected through what? It's different religions worshiping the same what? Morning star? The sun? The one that rose? His birthday is the 25th. That's when he fell. And then after that, he rose 3 days later. Drops to the 22nd, 23rd, 24th, 25th. That's 3 days. And then the sun goes back up, and that's Christmas, right? Be not like the heathen, because they deck the halls, right? Isn't Christ and Christmas the same fucking thing? Don't they show you a baby being born? One's the testimony. Raise your right hand. Put your hand on the word of the Creator, spoken by his prophets, altered by the oppressor. It doesn't matter. It still says what you need to know to grow. I didn't choose these things. So, let me show you something that's said in the Bible. Since we got a few minutes, we're hanging out together. So, I was like, show me what an Arab is. And then it says in what? What are they? Hosea. Joshua says what? Arab. The word Arab is used in Joshua. Now, Joshua is a book about, remember, Mecca's in California. Joshua is a book about the Israelites taking the land promised to them. Right? And what does it say? Ar-awab. Arawab, right? And it says from H693. It means to ambush. What do nomadic riders do? Right? Think about this. What do nomadic riders do? They ambush people. 693, that's up one, right? All rob, right? To lurk, lie in ambush, right? That's right there in the Bible. Just think about that. I didn't write that. Right? It's a thought crime to show you that. You know that, right? That's why I get letters from Google. Thought crime police. You're affecting our propaganda. Please. Have you guys looked at what is a person? What is a Negro? So, Dr. Tracy has made a video. Are Africans the real Indians? Now, this is very interesting. And I'm going to counter that video with Francisco Perez's video, America and Rome's Confederacy. This video actually answers something that's said. And it's very important how they are connected. So I think we're going to get into this in another video because Dr. Tracy's got a bunch of legal stamps on her stuff, but her perspective is so unique, to do that, it really puts a discredit to her task. If you sit there and say, and I'm not saying her in general, I mean a lot of people do this. Hey, look, I'm trying to educate people. Some people don't have the pieces. They're not willing to look at the pieces. Now, Dr. Tracy's clearly going to argue about the 13th Amendment being the way to make a slave. But she's not going to argue standing at law. She's not going to talk about us assimilating or us being assimilated. She's not going to talk about your resources being extracted. Today, she's going to take the time and call you a Persian. Instead of looking at all of these people being from the same heritage, Noah.